Tell me what's happened here. So how many protesters turned out at Liberty University? What were they saying?
So basically these protesters were essentially accusing President Falwell of being transphobic over these comments. And I think it's very interesting that these protesters, there weren't quite that many in the majority of the students that we have. There were probably about 100 in a generous estimate that were out on our steps protesting these comments. But the accusations, I think, are very unfounded. On the CPAC stage, President Falwell and Becky Falwell were essentially saying, here's what we personally do. Here's what we personally believe. They were purporting their personal beliefs at a conference which they hosted at Liberty University. They were not saying that somehow this is something that needed to be foisted on everybody in a free society. And I think that ripping those comments out of context is very detrimental to our national discussion on issues such as this.
Right, and that's a good point. It's always funny to me when liberals claim to be the party of tolerance. They're actually not. It's conservatives who say, listen, I'm going to be very open about what I believe, but if you choose to live your life differently, more power to you. That's your choice, even if I think it's wrong here. I will say, this is not exactly a fringe belief. I mean, not only is it mm-hmm. scientific, it's very mainstream in religious views and in the course of our entire history. Right. This is not a controversial thing to say. It was more a joke, it seemed to me, than anything else.
Right. Right. And I think that's exactly what President Falwell and Mrs. Falwell's comments were saying, is they were simply talking in a generally conservative environment at it as well, that this is something that we generally believe as Christians and conservatives. And for these students to then come out and accuse him and slap a label on his personal beliefs as being something that's detrimental to the body of our school, I think created a bigger issue than needed to be created. This was simply the president and the first lady of our university saying and purporting beliefs that they personally hold. The accusation that somehow they were trying to represent every single student or that they hate transgender students and LGBTQ students couldn't be further from the truth. I know a few personally. Many of them do not feel attacked at Liberty University. And I think ripping these comments out of context was really quite a detrimental thing to do.
Well, I think you hit the nail on the head. It's a media attack. They know, you know, the left knows that Liberty University is an evangelical school, that they purport evangelical Christian values and conservative political values. And so if they can possibly demonize that in any way to undermine Liberty's mission of sort of deputizing a new generation of young mm-hmm. people to live their lives according to Christian beliefs and conservative principles, well, they're going to take that opportunity.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.